you, Srimati Renuka Chaudhary.
Sir, Yantamando Mahanu Bavalu Andariki Navandanalu. Sir, I stand here today as a senior. I came here as the junior most. I was the youngest in parliament when I came with my daughter in her in a basket, and she was 3 months old. Today she's a mother, and I have a 3-year-old grandson. 32 years as witness to history of both Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha. I was a housewife who entered politics. It's not the typical formula, but that's how I am. I entered politics, was thrown into municipal corporation elections. I came 3 months later to Rajya Sabha. I was asked to resign from the corporation. I refused because I said I made a promise to the people, to my voters. So I was perhaps one of the few who was fortunate that I could serve the lowermost municipal corporation as well as the highest, where I saw policies being made for the nation. I got great satisfaction and learning from both ends because I saw what people really need, what is their demand, and what we plan for them. There's a huge chasm between them. There used to be a popular TV serial known as Rajni, where there was this interfering housewife who took on everyone's business. That was my first experience with the media, because when I first came here, there were headlines saying Rajni enters Rajya Sabha. And I came in that mode into this. And there was also a mistaken notion that I had come in, that I had a film background and I was an actress. I wasn't. I came and became a reactress in this house, where I reacted to situations. Sir, I also was fortunate that I was the entire opposition united candidate to contest against Najma Hepatullahji for the deputy chair here. And I was fortunate that I was, and R.K. Narayan ji called.
Garuda solved many problems.
Yeah. I was also called the Nightingale of Parliament by the then President R.K. Narayanan ji. And then I had Mr. M.F. Hussain, who never spoke for 6 years as president nominee, but brought out a book called The Upanishads.
It's K.R. Narayanan, not
Sorry, K.R. Narayanan. Parliament Upanishads, in which I was flattered and deeply honored that he wrote my name in the foreword of that book. So I was adopted across the party line, sir. I was indulged, lot of affection, learning and teaching. I came in to take an oath of allegiance and saw colleagues, and I'm leaving as two houses of friends. Yes. I have tremendous friendship and tremendous goodwill and good luck with all of them. I also have to say that I saw so many presidents, prime ministers, deputy chairs. One of the most charismatic was Rajiv Gandhi. When he used to sit here as prime minister, all the galleries used to be full. And everyone would fight with me when I fought with him on the floor of this house. So, and then Chandrasekhar ji as prime minister, who picked up the phone when I called him as a junior most and said there are riots happening in my state and my state is on fire. And he actually answered the phone. Those were the days where we said by the people, for the people. And I learned from Manmohan Singh ji the reticence of speech and how much silence speaks much more than loud noise on many fronts, sir. So having learned this, having seen all this, how can I forget the role of Sonia Gandhi? Not just as my leader. I cannot say that she was a woman. No, she was a leader for all. And a lot of things that she did and achieved for this country will always be remembered by all, because She didn't become prime minister. She had no such aspirations. It's her commitment to the people and to this country. And much of what she has gone through is like the daughters-in-law of this nation. No matter how much we do for our families, at the end of the day, we are the outsiders. So, sir, my journey as a woman here, there is no crash in parliament. You are bringing in younger people. When I came, I had a three-month-old baby. And the story remains the same. From Shahbano to Surpanaka, I have been witness to history here. And the lot of women hasn't improved tremendously. It's a pathetic 11% right, even now. I'm not fighting as a feminist.
Yeah, yeah.
But I really think we need more women. Mahila yahan aane se aap gender budgeting karenge, Jaitley ji.
Thik.
And I must confess, Jaitley ji has been one of the few gentlemen. So I've sparred with him, I've fought with him, but he has always upheld the
right,
dignity of women. And Ghulam Nabi ji, who has shouted, fought, guided, and all the elders who have been here, who right. have been
thank you very much, kindness,
sir. I want to just say, wait. Yeah. Jai Ram Ramesh is the obsessive compulsive interruption. So,
chalo.
Sir, I wanted to just say that all of us leave, we leave with.
I know her from. And she knows it also. Don't worry, you don't worry.
He knows me from many kilos ago.
Chalo. Chalo, Radhika ji.
So many people always worried about my weight, but in this job, you need to throw your weight around. So, you know, sir, I only have one thing to say. When we come, we take an oath. When we leave, we are not abdicated of that responsibility.
Very good.
We will go with the enrichment, the empowerment, and the wealth of experience that we have to continue to serve the nation where we are.
Thank you, ma.
I'm the daughter of a soldier and a practicing farmer. So I just say to all our friends, Tum aftab lekar chal. तुम आफताब लेकर चल तुम महताब लेकर चल तुम अपनी एक ठोकर में सौ इनकलाब लेकर चल
हेलो थैंक यू
बहुत बढ़िया
रिंगा मेरा सिंपल सुझाव है अपना वजन कम करके पार्टी का वजन बढ़ाने के लिए प्रयास करिए